Let's use the map growth collection. The first step will be creating subclasses. To do this, we will reference the class report, focusing on each student's percentile score. If you would prefer to start fresh, you can create a brand new class. We're going to use color coding to distinguish between our different levels of classes. We'll begin with our on-grade class, referencing it as the green class. Once I choose my grade level or subject area, and I click on the next button, I do have the opportunity to be able to add those mixed review starter bundle problems to my class. If I already have an established class that I would like to use as my on-grade class, I can simply use the settings menu to rename my class, again referencing that on-grade class as the green class. All students should be added to the on-grade or green class. You can choose to add students using the class enrollment link, or you can choose to add students manually to your class. Next, we will create a subclass for our students who have scored below the 40th percentile. Here you can see these students are highlighted in blue. So I am going to create a new class for the subgroup of students who have a percentile score of less than 40, and I'm going to reference it as the blue class. When I choose my grade level, I can choose the grade level that they're on, but I can also choose a lower grade level to ensure that those mixed review starter bundle problems that my students see are at a level where they will see that success. You again have the opportunity to add students either using the class enrollment link, or you can also choose to add existing students to your class. It will also be helpful to have the students change the color of their dashboard to blue. This will help both you and your student determine which class they are currently working in. Our second and final subclass will consist of those students that scored higher than the 85th percentile. Here you can see that these students are highlighted in purple. Just as I have previously done, I'm going to create a new class for this group of students, and I'm going to name this particular class the Purple Class. I can choose their current grade level, but I can also choose a grade level higher if I want to ensure that those mixed review starter bundle problems provide a challenge to these students. And once again, you have the opportunity to add students either using the class enrollment link, or you can choose to manually add students to this class. Just as we had done for the blue class, it will be helpful to have your students change their dashboard to purple for this class. The next step will be to create tiered assignments using the map growth collection. We'll begin on the Work tab and choosing a grade level from the middle column. Along the top, you'll want to choose the map growth collection. From there, you can click on any grade performance area where you will find a scaffolding, on grade, and enrichment folder. Prior to creating the tiered assignments, it is a great idea to create a folder for each lesson in order to better organize your work. The first assignment will be geared towards the blue class. Remember that students in the blue class have scored below the 40th percentile. In order to find skills for this particular class, we will focus in the scaffolding folder. Just as you have done in the past, you are encouraged to cycle through these problems to ensure that they are skills that meet your students' needs. The next assignment will be geared towards the on-grade class, or the green class. In order to find skills for this group, we are going to focus on the on-grade folder. So for this particular group, as a reminder, we included all students in the green class. We do encourage you to have all of your students work on the assignment within the green class. So this is why it's incredibly important to remember to model these skills for your students by either using the preview button or that full screen button. The final assignment will be geared towards the purple class. As a reminder, students in the purple class have scored above the 85th percentile. You will want to provide them with challenging work found within the enrichment folder of the map growth collection. The third and final step will be to assign work. We will begin with the green on-grade class. As a reminder, all students have been added to that green class, and we encourage all students to complete the on-grade assignment. So we will take the green assignment and assign it to the green class to ensure that all students receive on-grade work. The next step will be to assign that blue assignment to the blue class to ensure that those skills are available to that subgroup of students. But as a reminder, we want students working on the assignment on grade in that green class. We want the blue class to be available for students to be able to switch to when they're in mixed review. So we do encourage you to go to your assignments tab and make this particular assignment unavailable. That way your students are still able to access those skills when they're working in their mixed review. And finally, we will assign that purple assignment to the purple class to ensure that those enrichment skills are provided to that subgroup of students. Similar to the blue class, however, we want these students to work on grade on their particular assignment. We want these skills to be available to the students when they switch into the purple class for mixed review, so we will choose to make this assignment unavailable as well. Some suggestions for implementing the map growth collection in your classes. We do encourage you to have your students work within that on-grade green class as much as possible. So have all students complete the on-grade assignment in the green class. You should also encourage students to continue working in the on-grade mixed review. As the teacher, you can instruct your students when you want them to switch classes in order to work in a different mixed review. One last reminder. Since you have multiple students enrolled in more than one class, it may be necessary to refer back to the blue and the purple class to ensure that your students have met their daily goal.